If you're looking for the best gaming processor for a budget PC, there are only two options to choose, AMD and Intel. But what is the right choice? How do we know which company will give us the best value for money solution? To figure this out, we decided to arrange a battle between the i3-9100F and the Ryzen 1600AF. The last one has 6 cores and 12 threads, but the i3 has a higher frequency and more performance per core. Based on these two guys, we'll build PCs to cope with all games in 1080p with high graphics settings. We'll use the cheapest but at the same time optimal solutions, so these builds won't be suitable for future upgrades. What about price? It's the most important consideration for almost everyone, and AMD is hard to beat at this. But in our case, the 1600AF costs only 73 bucks more than the i3. What can we get by overpaying such a small amount? It is important to know that all components except motherboards and processors will be the same. For Ryzen, we have the MSI A320MA Pro motherboard and MSI H310M Pro VDH Plus for Intel. We're using GTX 1660 Super 4 graphics. This is the most balanced solution in the performance per dollar category. This card has a launch price of just 230 bucks, with comparable performance to the 1660 Ti at price 280. The 1660 Super is a cherry on top for many gamers because it offers amazing FPS in 1080p. There are no problems with noise, compatibility, and stability. That's why we've chosen this graphics card, but if you want to save some money, we wouldn't recommend you to buy something of a class lower than 1650 Super, RX 580 and RX 5500 XT. As RAM, we have chosen the Ballistic Sport 8GB kit for dual channel mode, and we'll just have the answer to the question that torments many people. Is it enough in modern projects? You can choose any drives you can afford. We recommend to take a 120GB SSD for Windows and a terabyte HDD for games. Power supply 500 watts is quite enough. We have a good PSU from FSP due to high quality reputation. Please welcome the ATX AeroCool Rift with the stylish RGB LED front panel. There is air cooling support in the front, top and back of the case to improve cooling efficiency. This is enough for our components. It comes with a full acrylic side panel to show the inside of your PC. From the top we see a pretty good I/O, 3 USB, audio jacks and other stuff. One cooler is already pre-installed on the back panel. We'd like to pay your attention to the fact that Wraith Stealth cooler looks much better than this ugly Intel one. I mean, come on, the design of this cooler looks like for the past decade. OMG, that is unacceptable. Dear Intel, solve this ASAP. However, these coolers will be sufficient and we'll use them now. Let's start with the Intel PC build. Open the socket, insert the processor, then close the socket. Then install the cooler, tighten 4 bolts and insert RAM. Click click, it's done. Now AMD. Processor, cooler, insert RAM, it's done. Now we take our hard drive, install it into the case, then attach the SSD, install the motherboard and insert the video card. We are fully ready to launch. We decided to test 8 popular games and 2 benchmarks. Well, the first is 3DMark TimeSpy, a modern test that will show us the real gaming performance of the PC and CPU. This benchmark is made with DirectX 12. The results are following. The Ryzen 5 scores about 6000 points, Intel Core i3 5500. Look at the difference in processors. The situation is sad for the blue team. The 1600AF is ahead of the 9100F by a large margin. Cinebench, the winner is obvious, 2700 for AMD and 1500 for Intel. After all, 6 cores and 12 threads dominate this benchmark for the CPU. Let me remind you that the Intel has only 4 cores without hyperthreading. Let's go test in the games. Maybe the situation will change then. All tests today will be performed in full HD with high graphics settings. They will be identical for the both builds. CSGO. In a special map, we see that Intel slightly bypassed Ryzen and showed 287 FPS in average. Intel has a higher frequency and unprincipled performance per core. You can see now all the monitoring and graphs with the final results on your screens. We hope that everything is conveniently shown. Although, an interesting fact, while the processor from the red is 20% loaded, the processor from Intel is up to 80%. Loaded. Shadow of the Tomb Raider, ultra settings. The i3 is 100% loaded almost everywhere and it leaves a rather unpleasant impression. In this regard, we have sagging FPS and the loss of frames. If we talk about numbers, you can see the results on your screens. Ryzen 1 2. I remind you that the difference of the price between these builds is only 40 bucks. Metro Exodus, complex built-in performance test. Status immediately appear on Intel Core i3 when it loads at 100%. It shows us more FPS, but it doesn't work as stable as 1600AF. It is especially evident in the game. AMD has 56 FPS, Intel has 57. By the way, this game uses only 5 gigs of RAM. Well, let's move on. Rainbow Six Siege, very high graphics settings, the situation is the same. The Core i3 has shown 198 FPS, it is 16 frames more than Ryzen 5 1600AF. Intel Core i3 is loaded to the maximum, the minimal FPS is much lower than in AMD CPU, 17 FPS against 54. Assassin's Creed Odyssey. We think Ryzen wins here because the game is very demanding on CPU power. The settings are set to a very high level. Even our Ryzen 5 CPU is 100% loaded. The average FPS you can see on the screen in yellow columns, 59 FPS for AMD and 54 for Intel. Red Dead Redemption 2. We see the same results for both builds, although again we pay attention to the CPU load. The difference is obvious, the i3 missed much more frames than the Ryzen 5. GTA 5. We love this game even though it is already 7 years old. The settings are very high, the Ryzen falls behind the i3 with only 2 frames. The Ryzen cooler works better, the temperature is very noticeable. The tests show the same results like in other games. The FPS is about the same, but the CPU's loading is very different. And the final test, Forza Horizon 4. Ultra graphics settings in 1080p. These two builds are doing a great job with this game. And the blue team's FPS is slightly higher again, 108 frames per second. However, in terms of game stability, AMD missed only 5 frames, and Intel 41. The Intel Core i3-9100F kept being 100% loaded at almost all games. It's not very good, because there are only 4 cores missing, and nowadays modern games need at least 8 productive threads. The only Intel fans could do is to wait for the new generation of Intel, which is rumored to have an i3 with 4 cores and 8 threads. This will be so cool, but we will find out about it this month. It's not long to wait. So Ryzen 5 1600AF is the most interesting processor for a low budget PC build. In all tests, it outperformed the Intel Core i3-9100F. Its power is enough for Full HD resolution with high graphics settings in almost all modern games. You can learn even more about this processor by watching our previous video, in which we have shown an awesome little budget PC based on the Ryzen 5 1600AF. You can see the link to the video now on your screens. By the way, speaking about links, you will find them for all the components used by us in today's builds in the description of this video. Post your comments down below and let us see what you think about it. Subscribe to the channel, thumbs up if you like it, don't forget about the bell, and we'll see you next week in our new video. Bye!